When we were in first year and second year, the debating had just started up, and like they come into our classes and we get to miss class. Was the first good part, but then the second part is like, they nearly become heroes too, because you're there like, wow, I really want to be like that when I'm older, so now we get a chance to do it. Even.
I went to Namibia in 2010 and I saw what it was like out there, and I was so interested in it. That's the reason I wanted to do it so much, is because I just wanted to learn more about the place and like all of Africa.
I just like talking, that's the only reason why I'm here.
every debate you think, oh, this is the last debate, this is definitely the last debate.
Yeah, but
and then this is definitely the last debate.
It was always kind of, oh, if we do well now, we'll get to the next stage, and sure, that'll be great. Like,
yeah, if we get to the next one, we'll be fine.
Well, wouldn't it be amazing if we get to the final 16 and now we're here, you know? It's,
yeah.
Last year, we got to the top 16 for the first time, so to get to the final.
It's amazing.
Out of 120 schools that originally took part, we're now down to two. We're down to two that have fought a very hard fight together.
What amazes me is how sanguine and how relaxed they are, because my memory of the brief debating that I did was sort of being a ball of fury and nerves in advance and then resentment directly afterwards. Whereas they're all saying, oh no, the opposition are lovely people and we look forward to chatting to them and all the rest.
At this stage, we're used to it.
Yeah.
We kind of are, because we've done it so many times that every time we get to the end we're like, oh, there was no reason to be scared, you know?
Yeah. It's here, so it's going to be nervous.
It's too early, anyway. Just wait for 5 minutes before and then
get nervous.
There was one point where I woke up this morning though that it kind of hit me.
Yeah. Well, you've been up in the middle of the night.
What's the debate tomorrow?
And here are the headlines. Tarr conviction sends warning to tyrants. Gender parity achieved in 17 sub-Saharan countries. Ethiopia takes a position as world's 10th largest livestock producer.
UNICEF says that 45 children have died during the reading of my speech. And you know what? Just as many will die during Ms. O'Brien's speech. Oppose this motion.
I think the students, yeah, they certainly develop confidence. They become far more articulate in a public environment.
Notwithstanding what you learn, it's the ability to control yourself and conquer your nerves.
To be able to get up in front of a crowd of people that like you might never see before, you see every day, like, and to be able to say something and to be able to get a message across to them is absolutely massive. Like, whereas before you'd be worried that they're not understanding what you're saying, but now you know how to get it across.
28 of sub-Saharan African states have been at war since 1980, according to Irish Aid. The Kenyan crisis killed 1,500 people and left 250,000 without homes, all in under a few months. The death toll from conflict in the Congo is literally 1,500 times greater than that in all of the Northern Irish troubles.
I wouldn't even talk in front of a class properly in third year now. Getting up in Astro Hall in UCD.
WHO tells us that malaria mortality rates fell by 33% since 2000. Georgie, you said the number of people dying of AIDS has not changed, but UNAIDS tell us the number of people infected with HIV fell from 2.2 million in 2001 to 1.8 in 2009.
We wouldn't have the confidence to stand up in front of that many people. What are you talking about?
And it's more about really the ability to recognise arguments, you know? I really love seeing that happen with them, where they start to realise, okay, that's an argument, there's different perspectives on this.
It's always good to see young people in a positive light and putting in an effort and into something they don't have to. And we hear too much bad news about kids smoking, drinking, taking drugs, whereas the vast majority of them are very good and very positive people and work well.
Yeah, and then there's general just persuasive skills, like even if you're not talking to a large group of people, just being able to convince someone that you're right on something, yeah, whatever that is, you know?
According to the UN news sector, enrollments in sub-Saharan Africa have increased by 48% since 2007.
I've always been educated in the debates, and you know, there's many of the topics that come up, and you'll be, probably hate to admit it, but you'll be fairly green as to the background of what'll be going on. I think, you know, you hear a wealth of information.
Your opinions, as our debaters would say, your opinions could easily change from what you think you believe. And then if you're told you have to oppose that motion, then
you could change your opinion completely by the end of the debate.
Poverty has affected all walks of life. It has stunted the very growth of a nation. It has suppressed their ability to rise above themselves. It has murdered innocent men, women and children. Yet the proposition are trying to convince you that there is hope. There is optimism. I'm afraid that ship has well and truly sailed.
I think the thing that debating helps you with is things that come in handy for either journalism or broadcasting or the law or for making presentations in business. It gives you a sense of how to structure an argument. It gives you a sense of how to persuade a group of people. And particularly if you're in second, third or fourth in the run of the debate, you need to get very good at adapting and adopting what people have said.
And it's really helped with the journalism course as well. You know, with confidence speaking from the camera and all that kind of jazz, you know.
When I used to debate with the concern when I was in school in St Mary's in Arbor, I was always the full speaker and loved a bit of the overload. Now I'm a DIT studying journalism, I'm swaying the globe, or maybe just my lecturers, on my views of politics, the arts, and the newest pooping robot. And I'm loving every minute of it. Although, when I joined the debating society on my first day, I found there wasn't one, and so I decided to set one up. The DIT Debate Society started with humble beginnings in 2011 with 20 odd members. But now we've around 200, and they're thrashing it out with university debate societies centuries old. To any of you debating at school now, I definitely would recommend taking it on. It's great for your confidence and well handy to make presentations at college.
And that's why I think the concern debates do so well, because they really get the students to delve deeper. The initial reaction is almost invariably, oh, we don't want this side of the motion, or the other side is much more difficult, or the other side is much easier. But they'll usually find the complexity to it and they'll start to see that.
We had to argue that the West isn't responsible for child labour, and everybody thinks they are, and the facts we found actually categorically proved it. And it was kind of cool to get a message out there that we never even knew was real at all, you know?
Well, I was against the GM foods and we had to be for it, so that was kind of awkward.
Yeah, the GM crafts one was really interesting.
It was just interesting to research as well, because you find out so much about it and I didn't know anything about it before.
I wonder, does Mr. Wayne feel the pain of countries such as Swaziland, whose life expectancy rates have plummeted to mere 31 years of age in the past 20 years? Does the optimistic proposition hear that in the next 7 years there will be 9 million new AIDS orphans?
You can see them blossoming all the way through.
They become celebrities around the
Yeah, and what was it that the vice principal is calling them?
Four musketeers.
Like a lot of the second years, like they like come up to you and they'll be like asking you, "Are you ready now?" And you know they're like so pumped up for it, like, and they're like loving it. Like
in our school, they read them for the classes to practice. So we've all seen them for like
quite a lot.
Quite a few times.
After years of stagnation, sub-Saharan Africa's economic growth has flourished. According to an article in the Sunday Times, February 26, 2012, 6 of the 10 fastest growing economies in the world are African.
We've huge support coming up from all the way from Bandon, long journey, and all the rest from West Cork, which they're all up for the final, so it's taken off big time in the school. So.
Yeah, the amount of people wishing us good luck this morning was on people around the
never
school.
Yeah, you've never
been.
They're like, good luck, and you're like, thanks, you.
And I would appeal to the Minister for Education to consider giving credit to this type of learning as he examines the process of the reviewing the Leaving Certificate curriculum.
I've definitely been enlightened about what's going on in Africa, and it has heightened my interest in it, like, and you know, there'll be something on the news or that you'd always listen to it intently and say, yeah, I heard that before, like I heard that somewhere else, and it's almost inevitably I heard it during the debate somewhere.
And it's brought debating, it's kind of seen now as more something kind of cool within the school, like there's a huge drive for it now, like all the second year students and the junior students are all saying, oh, you know, when can we go debating?
It's a massive commitment, but the end result is worth it, really.
That motion tonight has been defeated.
The winners of the Concern Debates 2011-2012 National Finals, Georgie.